Hello, beautiful people. I prepared a deck today from SKELLIGE. We are focusing mainly here on beasts and also on rain, but mainly this is a beast deck with some additional of you know, messengers of the sea, because obviously you know, I love this card. This is my favorite card in the game from the very beginning of this when I started playing GWENT, and also rain was my favorite archetype from the very beginning. Unfortunately, you know, it got a little bit of the meta right now. It's you know, going back. Is it that strong? Not as much, most probably, but it's strong enough, you know, to be competitive, you know, at some games. So we're gonna utilize here Rage of the Sea leader ability. Order: spawn rain on an enemy row for 2 turns and a defending siren on the opposite row. So make sure that you will use this charge wisely, because you would like to use both of the charges, you know, in the first round. Of course, one of them it's good, and maybe the second one in the second round, and then, you know, in the third round you will just have to you know, depend on the other cards that produce rain. Mask of Ouroboros, this is our consistency card, and mainly here what I try to get rid of, it's gonna be Elder Bear, because this is only like 4 points of provision for 6 points of power. Other than this, you know, obviously we will not be always on blue coin, and even if we are, not always we're gonna draw Elder Bear. Then basically it varies. If you feel like, you know, the other guy doesn't play all these new cards and that are going to include these echo cards, then obviously you can just spam Squirrel. Fucusya, and Fucusya can be played in ways. Of course, obviously we can play her into defender, we can play her into Kelpie, we can play her into a corrupted Flaminica, but first we have to count the cards in the graveyard, because after the rework, the ability of Corrupted Flaminica is changed, and right now it's boost self by 2 every unique beast in your graveyard. So not only beasts, but they have to be unique. This is also very important. So just you have to do quick counting, and just, you know, figure it out what is the best for you. Obviously, another target is Messenger of the Sea. So we're gonna get Messenger of the Sea plus, you know, 4 turns of rain. What else? Basically that's it. The other things are mainly, you know, just the fillers. Anyway, let's go here. Of course, Oneiromancy, it's a consistency card, it's an echo card. Heatwave, our talk control punish option, and of course obviously against any kind of scenario. Melusine, we need to make sure that we're gonna play her in the first round. Then we can, you know, once again bring her back. We can summon her with Sigfrida's Rite, and do something like, you know, a bleeding in the second turn. Of course, obviously, if we're gonna win the first round. Regard Decree, another card that we need for consistency. Convent of Steel. I included this card because I find it, you know, very useful, especially that we can play this card twice. So if you are ready to use Messengers of the Sea, you need to give them a little bit of protection. Other than this, we would have to use something, you know, against poisons and against locks, and then we would have to, you know, include Gremist. So guys, it's up to you. You know, this deck can be versatile. You can make some additional changes, but in my opinion, it's just better to use Convent of Steel, especially that we have, you know, Fucusya, and also we have Sigfrida's Rite, so we can, you know, use this defender twice. Kelpie, amazing card. Deploy, spawn rain on enemy row for 0 turn. In our cases, we're gonna have 4 turns of rain, so that's plenty. This value is increased by 1 for each beast in your starting deck. And as you can see here, it's not about unique beasts, but it's about beasts. So we can see that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And, you know, this is like additional beast, just in case. This one is already discussed. This one is also already discussed. You know about this one, you know how important it is. This is a crucial part for our deck. And due to the fact that we are playing also here Freya's Blessings, so we're gonna use the Messengers of the Sea 4 times. So we're gonna have four tokens that we're gonna produce massive amount of points. Delirium, I included this card because this is alchemy, and it also gives 6 points of damages. It's also like, you know, mid-range, I would say, removal, but sometimes we are having this difficulty that we are facing a unit that needs to be destroyed, but you know, using Karanti Heatwave, it's like an overspill, you know. That's why you need to also have some kind like a lock, or if it cannot be locked because it has Veil, then Delirium, you know, it's on our hand. Scepter of Storms, another artifact that we're gonna create some additional rain for us. Crow Messengers, so make sure that one is in your hand, the other one is in the deck. Also, obviously, once they're gonna end up in your graveyard, then by utilizing Freya's Blessing, you can bring back both of them in this way. Anglerfish, this is our another consistency option after the Crow Messengers. So you need to make sure that in both of the rows, during one round, you have rain. Then they're gonna be summoned, and then you need to make sure that in both of the rows you have if in at least one of the rows you have rain. But sometimes, you know, guys, you need to also you know, consider the fact that maybe we are, you know, like we use too much, you know, we have too many points on board, and maybe it's gonna be a good idea to, you know, instead of summoning them, just summon them back to the deck so they can be reused in the second or the third round. That's also an option, you know. Tears of Siren, this is another alchemy card, and this is also a rain producer. And why am I concerned about this alchemy archetype? Because the thing is, you know, about the Crow Messengers, that if you hold an alchemy card, also summon all copies from your deck. So you also, you always need to be sure that you have, you know, some alchemy card in your hand. That's why I included more cards like this. And for instance, according to me, it's enough. Right now, I was you know, doing I think everything correctly, and I was always getting the Crow Messengers. So we have Delirium, we have Sigfrida's Riot, and we have Tears of Siren. So we have three alchemy cards, and and of course Freya's Blessing. So five altogether. So then it's plenty, and then for sure we're gonna get them in order to summon Crow Messengers. Elder Bear, it's just a beast. Little Havfrue, it would be the best if you could play both of them in the same round. So the first one, we're gonna have 6 points of power, and the second one we're gonna have 8 points of power. Square, you know, right now unfortunately it's played a lot. That's why, you know, we are also, you know, going with this trend, and I also included in this deck. And Seagull, this is another beast, and you know, it's like, you know, some kind of, you know, small damage, you know, unit. As you can see, you know, for now, for this part of the season, I didn't include Ryogan, and I'm 100% sure, you know, that this card would pay off. But since everybody's playing Squirrel, and sometimes even they are playing you know, Xavier, so I find it, you know, basically useless, you know, wasting, you know, such a great potential of this card, you know, for basically nothing, you know. That's why, you know, I made some changes, you know, and that's it. That's the final version of it. For sure, guys, you're gonna enjoy it, you know. There are, of course, some things that you may consider. Maybe you would like to play something different. Also, you know, another good card in this deck would be definitely Axel Three Eyes. Yes, that's how I think he's called, because, you know, he plays this alchemy card, you know, we are creating some beasts, you know, this is a good option for Fucusya to be drawn by her later on in the game. You can of course experiment with this. You know, I'm not saying this is like the best version ever, but what is good about it is that you have a sufficient amount of rain. It's not like it's overspilling. You know, definitely you can use one of the charges in the first round, and then you can use the second one in the third round. You know, and then you will still have some kind of rain options. Maybe just try to, you know, play accordingly, and just focus on the points. Because also regarding this anglerfish, sometimes, you know, it's good to have them on board. Sometimes it's an overspill. Maybe it's just better to use them in the second round, you know, for breeding. That also could be an option, because then we would get 6 points. So you need to consider some facts over here. I need to, you know, guys, you need to play over here wisely, because unfortunately, many guys, they are playing with control decks, and this deck is fragile. That's why we have defenders. That's why we also try to protect ourselves with some kind of, you know, control options. Otherwise, you know, if you would just play a typical rain deck, you know, as we should, in fact, because it would be, you know, amazing, and that would be the greatest fun for us. But unfortunately, you know, right now the cards that being used, you know, they are pushing us into the a little bit like a more control side. So that's all for now, guys. I'm gonna record another movie with monster. I mean, already recorded. I just need to upload it also. And thank you guys for watching. Thank you for your time and support. See you guys in the next video. Please like, subscribe, and comment. Feel free to give me any kind of suggestions in the comment section. And yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. And the last announcement, please go to the nearest shelter and adopt a dog. Thank you very much, guys.
My beauteous Calanth.
For you, my friend, a special offer.
In the end, the sea. Beautiful pair of legs, please. Drown yourself with those damn nets. Serve her who is virgin, mother, and crone.
Let's get this over with.
I fish breath? How dare you, foul swine!
We'll show you how blood spilling's done!
Thank you.
protect you from all evil.
The North shall tuck tail and beg for mercy.
Attention, please. I shall now speak.
We'll show you how blood spilling's done.
Oh,
goody. I was getting bored.
Shall not repeat Amir's mistakes.
Melusine sends blessings. We pay her with reverence.
Optimum dosage teeters on the precipice of lethality.
Thank you.
my niece.
Bribe me, dimwit. You're supposed to bribe me.
It's a wild place. Wild.
The goddess protect you from all evil!
Cut my paws off, I bite you to death!
A presence gift from the gods is each day.
This message is with the Lord. His eyes only.
I will not have you gaze at me, sir.
Mordrem Freya is patient, but she brooks no insult.
Clean that up. Dissection is science, not child's play.
I fish breath? How dare you, foul swine!
Bow before Mordrem Freya.
Peace.